Better, yeah? Okay, cool. Whatever, I just wanted to show this. You can all check it out, and maybe there are some issues you're interested in. So I had a kind of a standby talk prepared for today, in case someone would like more speakers would drop out or whatever, but greatly we could figure out a solution for most things. So I just will show like one vertical slide of my talk, and maybe it's interesting for you, maybe not. I'm talking some blockchain stuff, introduction I'll skip for now. You will hear more about me tomorrow morning when I give my test containers talk. Something when I'm talking about blockchain and what can sometimes motivate me more is see a little bit the historic context and give it an interesting historic twist. If you see how computing as a resource, as a utility resource, developed from back then, from the time sharing systems to what we have now in a connected network world. And here we have a cool picture of Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie while they were developing Unix. And so one thing that started this whole blockchain trend was, of course, this very important paper by Satoshi Nakamoto, the Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash system that like started the whole cryptocurrency thing and with Bitcoin and so on. And we have this interesting quote here. It's called, we have proposed a system for electronic transaction without relying on trust. And I just want to give the question to the audience. Do you think Bitcoin is a system that does not rely on trust? Who thinks it does not rely on trust? Okay, who thinks it does rely on trust? Okay, someone has an answer on who you have to trust? Yeah, so in the end, like what I would say, you have to trust the code and the system, and like a lot of things you have to trust, like trust is a social concept also. But what it allows for us is that we got a new trust architecture. So classically, we had those peer-to-peer trust architectures, like you and I, we can have a mutual peer-to-peer trust relationship, a human trust relationship. We have something like a Leviathan trust, where we are trusting in a contract, that contracts are enforced according to our society. We have, of course, the intermediary trust. We're trusting our banks to perform the transaction however we want, and so on and so on. And now, with those blockchain thingies, we have this new concept of distributed trust, where we trust this technical system that enforces this trust in a distributed nature on a technological level. But still, and here I like to quote this speech from Thompson, from Ken Thompson, when he got the Turing Award, it's already in 1984, and he said, it was called Reflections on Trusting Trust. To what extent should one trust a statement that a program is free of Trojan horses? Perhaps it is more important to trust the people who wrote the software. And whenever we are like thinking about trust, which is a very human concept, and we apply it to those technical systems, keep in mind, at one point we have humans writing this code, we have humans operating those machines, at least to a certain degree. So there are still many human social trust relationships in those systems. And yeah, I will skip on this. I just wanted to highlight this topic. And now what I actually wanted to show you is one cool blockchain, in my opinion, cool blockchain application. We are working on a blockchain network. So I'm a head of the blockchain research lab at the Institute for Internet Security. It's in Gelsenkirchen, very nearby, part of the Westphalian University of Applied Sciences. And we have one public blockchain network we are operating. We are one of the operating nodes. We operate it together with other research facilities like universities, like Max Planck, like Fraunhofer, and so on. The name is Bloxburg, and the idea is to provide a public blockchain infrastructure, a trustworthy research infrastructure for science use cases that need this distributed trust architecture. There are certain use cases that might benefit from this, others not. And in general, this is a vision, and of course you can't read what it says there, but these are ideas we have in general for possible use cases that can be developed on such a blockchain infrastructure. And we have things like open peer reviewing, we have things like more open publishing of science data, of raw data, or we have a certification of research data, the existence of research data. And this is actually a use case that is already implemented. I will show you this in a second. The whole network is run as a so-called public permission blockchain. Means we have a consortium, the consortium of those research organizations and institutes, national, worldwide actually, international. And they together operate those networks, those infrastructure for free, basically. And there are certain rules, governance rules, how those network operates, and it is enforced on chain, meaning the rules who is allowed to operate in this consortium are enforced by code, that is a smart contract inside the blockchain. Yeah. Of course, now here we have to trust if this voting happens that the actual smart contract code is correct. And yeah, who knows if it is. So it looks good, but I don't know if it has been proven yet. And yeah, this is the actual use case that we have already. It is a certification of research data. So just think, you have research data and you have to prove that you already obtained this data at a certain point in time without sharing the data itself. So you just want to share in the future that you already had certain data at a certain point in time, but you don't want to make the data public at this point in time. And this is a use case that many research facilities need. If you think about patent law and so on, it comes into play there. And the idea is to have this certification, proof of existence of a certain data in this trustworthy infrastructure operated by research facilities. Yeah, and here we have the code of this, but we will actually look how it looks when we want to use it. So wait, this is the website of Bloxburg. This is a so-called DApp, so applications that interact with a blockchain or with a DLT, distributed ledger technology, they are called DApps, distributed applications. And the idea is that you have a part that is running on your computer, like a client, this is now a JavaScript client, and then you have a distributed component that runs in this network with smart contract code, Ethereum code, whatever. Here we will just now try to certify some data. So I will just, okay, I just put a file here, like there is a file, it's called answer, and the content is 42, so very important research data I have here. Wait. All right, and now I want to certify, I want to prove that I already obtained this data now, at this point in time. Yeah, but without sharing this very critical information, this answer. So what I can do, I can just use this web app now here to certify it. I can generate it from the file or just insert the hash directly. So we don't want to put the data itself on the blockchain. We just want to put the hash of the data on the blockchain. And it's a SHA-256. And I can just do it here. It's then hashed in the JavaScript. We see here, okay, hash. Okay, now I type with one hand, Kevin. Took some metadata that gets saved together with the hash. What did you say? Yeah, I can do this because it's public infrastructure. You can spam public infrastructure. You can spam email also. So public infrastructure that's unmetered needs to be able to live with this, in my opinion. All right. Oh, wait, now I couldn't do it because my MetaMask should be logged in. Okay, whatever. Then it didn't work. So I haven't tried out the demo now. One second. Okay, sorry, I can't show you how it works. But normally now it would open up this browser thingy, MetaMask, to perform the transaction on the blockchain. Sorry, also my time is over. You all want to go to the party? Yeah, so normally this is how it would interact, like this pop-up would go out from MetaMask and then it does a JSON RPC request into the blockchain. It actually, like the interaction is kind of simple. It's just like any other client-server application. So calling smart contracts that operate in the blockchain is just like calling a REST API, so not that complicated. Yeah, and in May we have a Bloxburg hackathon planned at the university in Gelsenkirchen, the Fische Hochschule. Will be a single day. It's open for students, open for developers. Everyone is interested to do some hacking, some programming with blockchain technology, with smart contracts on this infrastructure, Bloxburg infrastructure, which everyone can also currently use for free. Yeah, and cool. Yeah, that's it for now. And tomorrow you hear more from me from Test Containers and then Niklas wants to have the last words.
I think yes. I have. Has anyone questions to the blockchain before? But I have an important mark. You should change your logo because you should switch to Bibi Blocksberg. It's a German witch. You do some magic. Probably also the blockchain does also some magic. Yeah. This could be really better for the logo. So.
Also, I agree with you said before in your talk that I mostly try to use technology that has a good logo.
Yeah. So we need to improve there. But you can hire me as a consultant for logo defining and so. No more advertisement at all. Yeah, so I think we won't end this talk right now. It was really cool that we have so different lightning talks with so different views and also that we see so many different things today. Tomorrow we will be back at 9, so Kevin will be also the first speaker. So when you are also sitting right here, you will see this same person. It's not that you drink too much beer or too much wine. It could be probably also that Kevin is also already here there and probably the important part will be test containers. Yeah, so then we would. Yeah, and so we will close the talks for today. The important point, the after party is downstairs, so grab a beer with us, eat some food, and we will enjoy the rest of the day. And otherwise, we see us tomorrow. Thanks for the day. I hope you enjoyed it. Otherwise, we see us tomorrow.